project is for engines 85, soon to be engines 28. It's a new class on embedded systems, basically programming hardware is kind of the baseline of it. The final project was making a car that has two different operational modes. It can just drive like an RC car or have an autonomous mode where it drives around by itself and uses a sensor to kind of detect obstacles. We were mostly working on the RC car portion of that because after doing it last year when we were all in the class, there were kind of things we realized that could be improved about the project. And so throughout the summer, we were working on improving those. First things first, we changed kind of the design of the car. So originally it had four motors and then the steering was done by changing the speed on either side of the car. And we changed to a full steering mechanism that has a servo motor on the front. So it steers like a normal car. It's got the front wheels moving. We also added a speedometer so that students could have another way to kind of add sensors to the system and build it, make it more robust. We redesigned all the parts that are going into the car kind of to fit the specifications we wanted, have space for the microcontroller, space for the battery. Throughout the course, you're learning different skills for writing code for the microcontroller and also how to interface with the world. So you have sensors that are taking information in, and then actuators, things like motors, or maybe it's a light that are kind of putting things out to the environment based on what the sensors are getting. And so throughout the course, you're learning how to use different sensors and different actuators. You'll learn how to just use a motor or just use a motion sensor or something like that. And then this project kind of is what's bringing that all together. So now that you've learned to use all these different components, you combine it into one big project. So just on this car, there's a radio receiver, and there's also a rotary encoder, so something for the speedometer, there's the display, there's the motors. So bringing all these aspects that you learn about separately together into a final product. All of us were exposed to this for the first time when we took the class this past winter. So it's really cool to have gone from not really knowing anything about this type of code, this type of thinking even, to being able to develop new things on our own. It was very exciting.